AABA form in A sections are used to tell the storyline similar to a verse form in the verse chorus bridge. The B section is for contrast. Here's an example. Notice this is AABA and then the reflection of that ABAA. This first, that is the instrumental version of A.
She won't let me. She's shown me her own. Isn't it good? No reason to.
Contrasting B section.
She asked me to stay and she told me to sit anywhere.
Thought when I first heard that song, does that mean he burnt your place down? And then I read in Paul McCartney's autobiography that John Lennon actually did say that it was either about lighting a fire or it was about burning her house down. Yeah, great. So at AAA, I'm not going to play an example of this, but it's a storytelling form. It's very old. It's almost like a poem that has exactly the same structure every single time, and it's great for storytelling. 12-bar blues is, however, also an example of AAA form, and with 12-bar blues, you have a couple of 12 bars as kind of like verses, and then instrumental solo, and the musicians don't have to know it, they can just play along because everybody knows the 12-bar. Sea shanties, there were, when first I come to Liverpool, those kind of tunes, there's a lot of those that were all AAA forms. Some bluegrass music is just AAA forms, but most of them are more AABA. Okay, let's move into the classical period now. Some classical music periods, just so that we get an overview historically of the periods that we're talking about. The Baroque period was approximately from 1600 until the death of Johann Sebastian Bach in 1750, because after Bach, everybody has sort of hung up their hats. Or should have. The tension is basically low to medium. Then came the classical period from 1750 to about 1830. Generally low tension, happy music, or pretty music. Romantic period from 1830-ish to 1900 was generally a lot of medium tension stuff, although there was some pretty high tension romantic music as well. And when they got to the Romantic period, I'm not really going to go into it later here, because basically that was the time when they said, we're not going to play by your rules anymore. And they just decided that they'd take all the forms and throw them out the window and just go wherever the heck they wanted to go after that. So that was kind of a cool idea too, and it led to the 20th century, but then everybody, I got the feeling that the 20th century avant-garde music was like a bunch of guys running around with their chickens with their heads cut off, trying, what are we going to do now? So then it became a real intellectualized kind of music, and like the 12-tone row is a system of all this. That's great, but you know, it has no meaning to me emotionally or spiritually. It's intellectual, it's interesting, like, oh, cool texture, or whatever, but, you know, who cares? I don't, anyway. But then, so what?
Listen to Alban Berg.
Berg, yeah. That, I'm not saying that there's not music in there, you know. Then, fortunately for me, the 20th century took another term into minimalism, which I really love myself. Composers like Philip Glass, Steve Reich, Teddy Riley, and Philip Glass is the best known of these cats. Minimalism and the tension is generally pretty low in it, which is another thing I like about it, because it's very focused. Let's now go back again to three classical music form templates. And this is just a brief introduction. The fugue is a Baroque period form. It's the pinnacle of the Baroque music form because it of the aspects that it embodies. I'll get to that in a minute. Theme and variations form, we're not going to... Yes, we are going to. We have an example of that by Mozart. Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Mozart's version of Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star was... that song's been known by a lot of different names through history. Avez-vous maman? Something like that, anyway. So Mozart did a theory, some variations on that that we're going to be hearing, and the sections, like we know about ABA and things like that, now contrasting sections, well, the theme and variations, he takes the theme, A, and then changes it, and changes it again, and changes it again, and changes it again, and then when he's finished changing it, he'll do A again, stick it on the end so that it closes off nicely. That's theme and variations form, very simple. That theme and variation form has a single theme, by the way, and the fugue has a single theme. This is an important point that I want you to remember, is that we're looking at these monothematic, single theme versions right now, because then we get to the sonata form, which came up in the classical period, and it has what looks like a very simple form, A, B, A prime. A prime meaning that it's A somehow changed by going through B. And these sonatas have two or more themes. Some of them have up to six different themes when you get to Beethoven. Baroque ideals. Why did the Baroque period have the stylistic qualities that it did? Well, the Baroque period embraced not just music, but architecture and painting and every other aspect of the arts and a lot of aspects of sciences as well. Logic and reason was highly regarded. That reflected itself in the music as counterpoint. Counterpoint being the weaving in and out of more than one melody and elaborate structures. Grandeur and opulence. I think a lot of this music that we're talking about in the Baroque period is music that was written for either the church, or which was very opulent. And there were also, a lot of this music was written for the court. And a lot of this music was not being written for the serfs that lived just outside the castle walls. I don't know what they were listening to. It would be wonderful if we could find out. But grandeur and opulence, triumphant power and control. So there's all these Baroque ideals. Bach, we're going to play an example from one of the Brandenburg concertos, and I left these points about logic and reason, counterpoint, grandeur and opulence, triumphant power and control on the screen, so you can think about those qualities being reflected in this short piece of music. Yeah.